Good, so we've described our statistics. Let's do it visually using the Gadfly package. Now, a whole bunch of lessons just on the Gadfly package. I'm going to show you the basics right here. Plot. Plot is a function and it takes various arguments. And you build up what you want in your plot very easily. The first thing, Gadfly is data frames aware. So you can just tell it what data frame you are going to deal with. So first argument, df data frame. Second argument, what do I want on the x-axis and what do I want the y-axis to be? So on the x-axis, I want the infections. Now, I've got to do this in quotation marks. I'm not going to use the colon in front and just the word. So I could say df square brackets and then the colon, but I can, because I've passed this data frame argument there, I can just use in quotation marks infection column. So remember the infections, we have minor and major. So those are the two things it's going to put on the x-axis. So those are not numbers, those are categorical values. Those are categorical values. Now, y, it's going to be the age. So it's going to go down the age column for y. But now I've got to tell it what I want to do with it, because there we have categorical data on the x-axis. On the y-axis, I've got numerical data. So one of the things that you can plot in that way, of course, is a box plot, just box and whiskers. And I say geom, which stands for geometry, with a capital G there, dot box plot. That's how you refer to the type of plot you want to do. And then three of the arguments I'll use quite often is guide.title, guide.xlabel, guide.ylabel, and you can just imagine what they are. Guide.title is going to put a nice bold title on the top of your graph. You pass an argument to it in quotation marks, and I'm going to call it age analysis by type of infection. So you can immediately see what's going to happen with this box plot. On the x-axis, we're going to have a box plot for minor infections and for major infections, and for each of those, we're going to do a box plot of the age. So Gadfly is going to extract from that one column age the values that belong to minor infection, the values that belong to major infection, and it's going to plot them as a box plot. That's wonderful. And I'm going to label my x-axis, guide.xlabel, the type of infection, which is minor major, and on the y-axis, I want to use this label function. I'm going to execute this. Now it's got to compile on the server side, on the Amazon Web Services, so it's going to take a little bit before we start seeing our first plot. So let's hang in there a bit. And there we have our very first, very beautiful plot. I have my title, guide.title is age analysis by type. I have my x-axis label, type of infection. I have my y-axis label. And two beautiful, we can change various things about this. I'm not going to do it now, but we have our two beautiful box plots there. We even see our outliers on that side. And we see if we hover, we can also zoom in and zoom out. And on the x-axis, it's found minor infections and it's found major infections. Let's repeat. I mean, that is beautiful. I love the colors, the default colors that were chosen. Let's just change the color. We're going to do the exact same thing, just for exercise sake. We call the plot function and the following arguments. The data frame, the x-axis, instead of infections, I want it to go down the gender column and find whatever it can. On y, the age, and it's also going to be a box plot geometry. So geom.boxplot. I'm going to have a title, so it's guide.title, an x label and a y label. This time I'm going to add something new though, a new argument, theme, and I pass to it the arguments the following. Default underscore color equals, now you've got to use, be careful, it's colorant and then just the quotation mark orange. So nothing in between there, no equal sign there, nothing. Just get used to how to write a color. There's a few keywords for color that you can use straight off the bat. So if I execute that second time around, things are going to be a bit faster. Let's have a look. And there we are in orange. Beautiful. So it found female and male. It attached the age values to it beautifully, and it drew our two box plots for us. Now, that is really, really professional. It looks fantastic, looks phenomenal. I want to show you a different type of... So we can start seeing things here already. See, we see that the age, we see major infection patients were slightly older than the minor infection patients. We can certainly see that. We can see that we had a bit more spread in the data as far as the age analysis of the major infection is concerned. Another type of graph that will show that to us even better is this density plot. So it takes the following arguments. Again, it's plot, Gadfly, the data frame, but on the x-axis, I want age. Now, age is just a string of the numerical values. You go from youngest to oldest. So what am I going to have on the y-axis? Well, I'm not going to call it y, I'm going to call it color. Not y, color. And for that, I want to look down the infection column. Now, remember, it's going to find two types of infection. Two types of infection, minor and major, and I'm going to pass that to the color. And then I'm going to call geom.density, because a density estimate on the y-axis gives us a density estimate of our data. So it's going to find minor infections and look at all its ages, and major infections and look at all its ages. Again, I'm going to just do guide.title, guide.xlabel, and guide.ylabel. Let me show you the plot. First time we're going to do a density plot, so it's going to think about it a bit. It's going to compile that. It's going to look through the data, and it's going to render the plot for us. There we go. That's what it does. So you see, I called the y-axis distributions because it is a density estimate. You see the values there. You see the values there. And now we can see the age distribution. See, from 0 age to 50. So this is a kernel density estimate of the minor infections and major infections. So I cannot pass a y argument here. It is part of the density geometry. I want it to find the two sets of ages, the minor infection age and the major infection age, and I pass that to the color argument. Now we can start to see, well, there's perhaps not a difference between... I'm going to put money down that there's no statistically significant difference in ages between major and minor infections. And it might be a bit difficult to see, not really, but it might be slightly difficult to suggest that just from the box plots. But these density plots really give you a lot of information. Let's do the same thing for gender. So again, age, but this time I want to do the density, kernel density estimates for gender. Let's do that, and you can see, as far as the gender is concerned, really the age analysis is almost identical. So again, if I compare males to females, as far as the age distribution is concerned, I'm not going to find, with a parametric or non-parametric test, I can say a statistically significant difference. Let's do some more box plots, just to have a look at our data. So I'm going to go on x-axis infections and the HbA1c, comparing major and minor infections. All the other things the same. I've given descriptive words to the title, the x-axis and the y-axis labels, and we see there is a big difference. Now, remember, this is just fake data. Probably you won't see anything like this, but the minor infections seem to have had higher HbA1c than the major infections. I'm going to go through this rather quickly now. You know how to write the code for these plots. Let's rather concentrate on the data. If I look at HbA1c, major and minor infections, as you see, we saw that big difference in the box plots, but look at the kernel density estimates. We can beautifully see. Just a reminder, I don't pass a y argument, I pass the color argument. And on the x-axis, I want the HbA1c percentage values. I don't pass y because the density will be calculated for me. Let's look at box plots just by gender. If we look at box plots by gender, we see there isn't really any difference. But look at those plots. They are lovely. And let's just pass a box plot for CRP versus infection. And we see the major infections quite a bit higher in the C-reactive protein. And lastly, if we just look at CRP analysis by gender, we see they are rather equal to each other. So box plots and kernel density estimate plots, it helps you so much to get to grips with your data. Look at the code that has been written to generate these. Gadfly really makes it easy for you to plot your data. In the next section, we are going to start doing some inferential statistics, which is what it's all about.